Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
We gather in heaven's meeting place, O God of our world. In this place, where grace shapes us, love molds us, and forgiveness refashions us.
Meet with us again today.
We gather in honesty and expectation, O God of our world, in this place where promise gathers, longing haunts us, and good news renews us.
Meet with us again today.
We gather in Advent hope, O God of our world, in this place where incarnation calls us, light surrounds us, and prophecy transforms us.
Meet with us again today. Amen.
When the Lord comes, he'll bring to light the things now hidden in the darkness, and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. Live in a world oppressed by sin, a world of hunger, pain, injustice. We acknowledge that we have not always played our part in confronting darkness with the light of Christ. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We are part of the body of Christ, broken by the sin of its members. We recognize that we are part of that broken body, our sin affecting others. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
We are each created in the image of God. We confess we don't live up to God's dream for us, living apart from him, afraid of the power of his love for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, purify our hearts and minds. When your Son, Jesus Christ, comes again as judge and Savior, we may be ready to receive him, who is our Lord and God.
Amen.
And the collect for today. Almighty God, as your kingdom dawns, turn us from darkness of sin to the light of holiness, that we may be ready to meet you in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
This is our first reading.
On this mountain, the Lord hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wine straight clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all people. The sheet that is spread over all nations, he will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken, it will be said on that day, Lo, this is our God, we have waited for him, so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation, for the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Hallelujah. Hear the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
After Jesus had left that place, he passed along the Sea of Galilee, and he went up the mountain where he sat down. Great crowds came to him, bringing with them the lame, the maimed, the blind, the mute, and many others. They put them at his feet, and he cured them, so that the crowd was amazed when they saw the mute speaking, the maimed whole, the lame walking, and the blind seeing, and they praised the God of Israel. Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I have compassion for the crowd, because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat, and I do not want to send them away hungry, for they might faint on the way. The disciples said to him, Where are we to get enough bread in the desert to feed so great a crowd? Jesus asked them, How many loaves have you? They said, 7 and a few small fish. Then, ordering the crowd to sit down on the ground, he took the 7 loaves and the fish, and after giving them thanks, he broke them and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. All of them ate and were filled, and they took up the broken pieces left over, 7 baskets full. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Want to sit down? So we've reached Advent, that time of preparation for the celebration of the coming of Jesus into our world. It's a time, of course, when we're invited to look in 2 directions, isn't it? To look back to the first coming of Jesus, and to look forward to the second coming. The theologians have fun trying to decide how to talk about the coming of the kingdom, which is what Jesus came to do. Did it come then, or was it going to come then? I think the easiest way is that Jesus came to begin something which he's going to complete one day. And we're living between those 2 points. And the kingdom he came to bring, of course, was a very different kingdom to the one that was around in his day and is around in our day. It's a kingdom where love rules. There's a very particular kind of love. There was a sort of love around in Jesus' day, but it was very limited, and in a sense quite exclusive. But the significant thing about Jesus' love, of course, is totally inclusive. And he was forever getting into trouble for practicing inclusive love. He included lepers, dared to touch them. He included loose living women, who he dared to talk to in the street. He included beggars lying in gutters that nobody else would bother with. He included tax collectors that wouldn't even go to their home for tea and was criticised no end for fraternising with sinners. But Jesus was demonstrating inclusive love, which is a key central feature of the kingdom he came to bring to our world. And it's that love, that kind of inclusive love, that he will bring completely when he comes again. And in the meantime, you and I are left living between those 2 points. What might be expected of us? Simply, the challenge is to live by the standards of the kingdom now. The standards that Jesus brought when he came first time, the standards which Jesus would look for when he comes the second time, and right now, we're invited to live that way. How inclusive is our love as we live our lives day by day? We don't have to look far down our streets, across our land, across the world, to see in too many places love is limited to certain people. The love of the kingdom of God is totally inclusive, and he invites us to live that way today while we wait for his return. And in view of that return that we wait for, This time of year always reminds me of an incident that I experienced a long time ago. I know I've been coming to Thornhill on and off for years, and I may have told you before, but I never mind telling this again. Eons ago, it's over 70 years ago, I was a student in York. If you know York, you know the street of Stonegate, one goes up to the south side of the Minster. I actually lived at the top for 3 years, looking down Stonegate, which is brilliant. But about three quarters of the way up on the right-hand side, there's a little shop with an overhanging first-floor window, a lot of them do have in York. And in the days when I was there, in this shop and in the flat above lived an elderly lady called Mrs. Clark. That's how you addressed her in those days, wasn't it? Mrs. Clark. And she was a devout Christian. But she took it upon herself to welcome, support, and pray for every Christian student she came across. And I used to go into her shop whenever I was passing, and she would take me through into her back room. Kettle will be on the hearth. All she saw in her shop were sort of Bible texts she put onto plaques and covered and sold, and tracts. That's all she sold. And her back room was covered with them. But what I'm reminded of as we come to this time of year is that prominent on her mantelpiece, right opposite her favourite chair where she sat, was one of her own plaques. It had just two words on it. Today, perhaps. And that was a simple way of her being reminded, and those of us who joined her in her back room, that Jesus could return any time. And those of us who knew Mrs. Clark would say she'd be ready. She'd have a suitcase packed, probably say to Jesus, "What kept you?" and be off. She's one of those people you sense was so ready to meet the Lord. I give thanks to Mrs. Clark whenever I think of her, and particularly this time of year, and that challenge, that simple block. Today, perhaps, Jesus will come, the one who began the kingdom with his inclusive love, will one day complete the kingdom with its inclusive love, and in the meantime invites us to live by that same love between those two points while we wait for that day, whenever it is. May we wait and watch with faith. So let's pray. Father God, the world we live in is in desperate need of that inclusive love that Jesus came to talk about and demonstrate in his own ministry. In so many places, there are significant divisions between people. There's hatred and fighting rather than love. Lord, you call us, you challenge us to live by the standards of the kingdom that Jesus came to bring. Help us in our own way to live lives of inclusive love amongst our family, our friends, our neighbours, our colleagues, and whoever else we engage with. May your kingdom come in us, even in these days. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for some of those places in our world where there is such tension, such fighting, such division. And we think of the countless thousands, millions of people who suffer innocently because of it. Those who end up in refugee camps. Those who choose to travel dangerously to find a better life. And sometimes lose their lives doing so. For the desperate in our world, desperate for food and sanitation and shelter and healthcare, places like Yemen, Afghanistan, and others too. cry to you for your world and all who suffer in it. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for all in power in these days, in the world, in various countries, including our own. We pray for wisdom, for integrity, for compassion, as leaders lead their people. May they do so generously, selflessly, and in love for those they serve. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We pray for the church in these days, called to proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God and to demonstrate that inclusive love which is a central feature of that kingdom. We pray for the church across the world. We pray for the church here at home. We pray for our leaders, national and local. We pray for the witness of this church in this parish at this time. And we take a moment to remember many fellow Christians in at least 60 countries of the world, who as we sit freely here worshipping, are severely persecuted because they're Christian. We remember them and we pray for them. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And remember those who are struggling with life right now, for whatever reason. Some may be anxious about work or finance, others about health, physical or mental. We pray for them, especially those we know and love, especially those on our church, parish list, needy list. Lord, whoever they are, whatever their need, we pray you'll be there with them and for them and bring peace to their lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We remember those who walked this life before us, a life of faith and love. We give thanks for them, especially those we know and love still and remember. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And so for ourselves we pray, that challenged by the kingdom of God and its central feature of inclusive love, we pray we may be people inspired by your Spirit, challenged by the coming of Jesus, first time and second time, we ourselves may be people of inclusive love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Would you like to stand? In the tender mercy of our God, the day spring from on high shall break upon us, to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
In an appropriate way, do share peace rather than another. Blessed be God, by whose grace creation is renewed, by whose love heaven is opened, by whose mercy we offer our sacrifice of praise. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and good to give you thanks and praise, Almighty God, the everlasting Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son. For when he humbled himself to come among us in human flesh, he fulfilled the plan you formed before the foundation of the world, to open for us the way of salvation. Confident that your promise will be fulfilled, we now watch for the day when Christ our Lord will come again in glory. And so we join our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven to proclaim your glory, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his commands, send your Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supped with his friends. And taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took a cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection till he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen,
Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, justice and mercy be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven, through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honour and glory are yours, our loving Father, forever and ever. Now let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread. To share in the body of Christ. Draw near with faith. See the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you. Feed on him in your hearts, by faith, with thanksgiving. Thou, O God,
who take away the sin of the world,
have mercy on us.
Thou,
O
God, who take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us.
Thou, O God, who take away the sin of the world,
have
mercy on us. Grant us peace. pray. O Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful, as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord, that when he shall appear, he may not find us sleeping in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord, that you have fed us with this sacrament, united us with Christ, and given us a foretaste of the heavenly banquet prepared for all believers.
Amen.
The star has begun to slide towards the stable, and the universe holds silence, and your promise slips into our world. We hear your coming again.
Great
God, hold us in this space, between now and not yet, as we long for your arrival. The journey has begun. A new young mother and worried father move towards an unknown future, wrapped up in a vulnerable promise. Great God, your love shapes this journey, between now and not yet, as we long for your incarnation. The time is not quite, and angels have yet to find voice. And in this heavy expectation, we hear the ancient echo of your prophecy. Great Lord, rest us in your patience, between now and not yet, be born in us soon. Now may God himself, the God of peace, make you perfect and holy, to keep you safe and blameless in spirit, soul, and body, for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you, those you love and care for, now and for always.
Amen.
As we await our coming Savior, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.